Okay, so hi everyone. I am Borja Nogales. I am a PhD student at the University Carlos III of Madrid, Spain, and together with Miguel Silva, who is a researcher at the Telecommunication Institute of Aveiro, Portugal, we are going to present our work in which we have used OSM to realize the deployment of a public safety vertical use case based on our aerial and vehicular NFV infrastructure. As you can see in this slide, I have included some contact information, so you can contact us after the presentation if you want to comment or ask anything, or even if you consider that it could be interesting to carry out a collaboration work with us. Finally, before starting with the content itself of the presentation, I would like also to thank Silvia and the OSM community for letting us be here presenting our work. So, okay, now regarding the key takeaways of our work, I would like to point out that the main objective of this work was to define an NFV framework capable of integrating heterogeneous NFV infrastructure with different capacities and capabilities in order to enable the cost-effective and the flexible deployment of different vertical network services. And in particular, for this work, we have included two remote and unique NFV infrastructures, one provided by the University Carlos III, in which we have a set of small-sized unmanned aerial vehicles, which are also known as SUAVs or drones, to provide with these devices the computational capacities that are needed for provisioning different VNF. And on the other hand, provided by the Telecommunication Institute of Aveiro, we have an infrastructure that it is capable of hosting the VNF in different automotive vehicles. Moreover, as we will see later in this presentation, this work also encompasses the description of an elaborate and a complex use case in the public with the aim of highlighting the practicality and the potential benefits of this proposed framework. In addition, it is worth mentioning that the full realization of this work has been based on open source technologies, especially as we will see afterwards, it has been based on OSM Release 7 and on OpenStack. Finally, in this work, we have also included a novel solution based on the publish subscribe model to carry out the configuration of the VNF in a more agile way for enabling the service deployments to be adapted more quickly to emergency scenarios like the one that it is contemplated by our use case. So, taking into account these key takeaways of our work, we will see now which are the main aspects that have motivated the realization of this work. First of all, as you may know, the new generation of mobile communications, or 5G, is gradually taking pace, and one of its most relevant milestones aims to a paradigm shift to enable the transition from a model in which communication services were mostly oriented to satisfy human communications towards a model in which the services provision entails the adoption of particular requirements exhibited by different industry sectors or verticals. So, in this context, two research lines intersected to address this challenge. On the one hand, led by the University Carlos III, we have the research line that it is in charge of deploying on demand different communication services using these drones or SUAVs infrastructure. And on the other hand, led by the Telecommunication Institute of Aveiro, we have the other research line that it is responsible for supporting the opportunistic provision of different communication services over an automotive infrastructure. As a result of this intersection, the definition and implementation of an overall NFV framework capable of integrating different NFV infrastructures that can be distributed across different geographical locations arises with the objective of supporting, as I said, the deployment of elaborated vertical services. Finally, I would like also to highlight that all the details of this work have been recently published in a research journal, and that this journal is open access, so you can find all the information about it using the link that we have included in this slide, okay? So now I give the turn to Miguel, who is going to comment how our framework is composed, as well as the main aspects of the previously mentioned public safety vertical use case. So Miguel, please go ahead.
Hello, everyone. Let's start by talking about our aerial and vehicular NFV framework. This framework is aligned with the design principles of the NFV architecture published by ETSI. It's a framework that consists of three NFVI point of presence. We have our core NFVI point of presence with high availability of resources in terms of computing network and storage, which is our core network domain. We have the SUAV's NFVI point of presence, which enables the execution of lightweight VNFs over the computational units offered by the SUAV devices. And we have finally the automotive NFVI point of presence, which supports the deployment of lightweight VNFs within vehicular networks. Our framework also supports the cost-effective and flexible deployment of the vertical services. Our framework can be seen in the figure present in the slide. One important aspect that it is worth noting is that in the core NFVI is where we see the NFVO, that in this case is OSM. Next slide, please. Let's start talking about our NFVI point of presence, starting with the core NFVI. This is an NFVI with high availability of resources, as I said previously, to accommodate services corresponding to the core network domain. It is located in 5G Telefónica Open Network Innovation Center in Madrid, Spain. The management and orchestration software stack is provided by OSM. As Borja said, it is OSM Release 7, and it orchestrates and manages the deployment of the service that will be hosted within the whole ecosystem. It includes two independently operated cloud computing platforms. The first one on the left, its purpose is to supply limited computing capacity to support the development of network services focused on environments beyond the edge. For the Veeam, we use OpenStack Okata, and the NFVI is comprised of two mini ITX computer service with KVM virtualization technology and 10 Raspberry Pis model 3B+, which support Linux container virtualization. The second platform, its purpose is to accommodate complex functions that may be expected in the core network domain. The Veeam is OpenStack Okata, and for the NFVI, we have three computer servers which use KVM-based virtualization as well. Next slide, please. The next NFVI point of presence is the SUAVs. In this case, each SUAV device comprises a computational unit that offers its resources with the aim of enabling the execution of the VNFs. The computational capability is provided by the single board computers. Given that we are in resource-constrained devices due to their compact size, we have to deploy lightweight VNFs. It also provides on-demand communication infrastructure wherever it is needed, either in areas where communication infrastructure is not provided or insufficient, for example, in rural areas. This SUAV NFV-based platform is equipped with OpenStack release pins for the Veeam, and for the NFVI, we have four SUAV units, which are model-powered Bebop tools, and 4 Raspberry Pis Model 3B with Linux container-based virtualization support as well. Next slide, please. The last point of presence is the automotive NFVI. Let's start by commenting briefly about the vehicular network. In this case, the automotive infrastructure is a VANET with mobility and multi-homing support based on the network proxy mobility IPv6 architecture. Its main components are the roadside units, which provide connection points for the onboard units. The onboard units are the units placed inside the vehicles, which provide connectivity to the end users. And the last main entity is the local mobility anchor, which manages the whole network and provides connectivity to the outside. We can see a simple representation of the network in the figure, where we see the vehicles, which have OBUs inside them, communicating with the roadside units, which in turn are connected to the LMA via wired link, and the LMA is connected to the internet. Next slide, please. To make up the NFVI, a general purpose hardware platform is connected to each OBU. This platform offers its hardware resources with the aim of enabling the deployment of the VNFs inside the vehicles. The resource-constrained devices, due to their small size, means that we have to deploy lightweight VNFs. The automotive NFV-based platform is equipped with for the automotive part, we have one RSU and one onboard unit, which are SBCs with .11p, .11b interfaces. For the Vim, we use OpenStack release Okata, and for the NFVI, we use one Raspberry Pi Model 3B with Linux container virtualization support, and we have one laptop computer with KVM-based virtualization. Next slide, please. Let's now talk about our use case and describe it. Next slide. Network service, road traffic surveillance. In this situation, we have dense road conditions expected due to the beginning of a holidays period. And to be on top of that, the SUAV's network and services are deployed by the Public Safety Department to improve the situational awareness of the road conditions. In the figure, we can see the services on both infrastructures. In purple, we can see the multi-site service that is deployed on the cloud and SUAV infrastructure, which is responsible for managing the overall communications. In blue, we can see the service that is deployed on the SUAV's infrastructure. These services are composed by different virtual functions capable of collecting relevant information, in this case, images and videos, and delivering them to the Public Safety Department in order to facilitate the decision-making. They are also capable of complementing the resources of cellular access network serving the users, and thereby preventing a potential stage of network traffic congestion. And finally, they are also capable of disseminating relevant information from the Public Safety Department to the users connected to the aerial network. Next slide, please. Creating an unheralded emergency service. In this situation, given the previously mentioned traffic conditions, an emergency has occurred. In this case, the municipal authority notices the emergency and adapts the functionalities of the service to address emerging demands by these altered circumstances. In this case, an emergency with a vehicle collision. For that, it integrates additional SUAVs, it modifies the SUAV's trajectories, it executes new functionalities and releases previously allocated resources. In this case, we can see in the figure the new service that is deployed, marked as green. This is a multi-site service that is deployed on the automotive, cloud, and SUAV infrastructures. This service contains new VNFs that will enable the communication from the UAVs to an emergency response team, whereas the team moves towards the location of the emergency. Next slide, please. In this slide, we present a table with the VNFs that are used in our network services. The main point that is worth noting is that all our VNFs were implemented by us using open source software. Next slide, please.
Okay, so now I get the ball again, and taking into account what Miguel has presented, and with the aim of verifying the ability of our experimental platform to adapt this emergency situation, we have analyzed the time that is required to have the deployment of the network services ready within our use case. So for this purpose, we have measured the time that OSN takes to consider the success in completing the deployment of each service. And in addition, we have repeated this process 30 times per service and depicted the results using box plot, as you can see in this figure at the top right hand of the slide. And the results show that the core service takes, I mean, the one depicted in purple in the previous slides takes about 4 minutes to be deployed. The service colored in blue is more or less the same. And the emergency service that was depicted in green takes about 13 minutes. Although these times may seem reasonable, the upward trend observed with increased number of the VNF of the emergency service leads to consider if our framework has the sufficient capability to manage this kind of emergency situation. So based on these results and with the aim of identifying at what stage the deployment times can be reduced, we have carefully analyzed how OSM operates through this instantiation process. In addition, we have repeated the service deployment times measurements, but this time preventing the VNF from being configured. As you can see in the lower part, in this occasion the times are far below from the previous results. So with this results and from what we observed in previous works, we can infer that the configuration process in OSM through UU requires such a high processing load that significantly delays the service deployment times. So in order to overtake this limitation, we have developed and integrated a novel solution to our framework that intends to decouple this configuration stage from the OSM stack. In addition, this solution considers the decentralization of the VNF configuration function, placing an instance of this solution close to the beam in charge of each NFVI or NFV infrastructure. So this way, we can avoid the processing overload for the host executing the OSM stack. In addition, this solution is based on the publish-subscribe model, and that's why we name our solution as publish-subscribe configuration function, or PSCF. So in this context, we have defined different information flows that can be shared by means of this publish-subscribe model, allowing the PSCF solution to firstly collect the configuration information that it is published by OSM associated with each VNF under the charge of the PSCF, that is those VNF that are allocated within its particular NFVI. And another different information flow lets this PSCF solution to determine when the VNF are ready to start the configuration process. And for doing that, we let the VNF to publish when they are ready or they are startup. So in this figure, we can see the summary of the synchronization operations that our solution follows to perform this configuration process. And finally, about the prototype of this solution, just comment that we use a virtual machine with Kafka installed for implementing these publish-subscribe operations, and also with the Ansible server to carry out the configuration, the VNF configuration action. So taking this into account, we repeated the service deployment time measurement, but in this case, using the OSM in conjunction with our PSEF solution. And as we can see here in this figure, this time are quite lower than the one obtained in the previous scenario. So with that, we can confirm the feasibility of our PSEF solution to reduce the service deployment times in a very specific scenario like this one with an emergency. So apart from that, our use case also includes a video service that aims to validate that the overall service can offer the expected functionality by means of the interoperation of the three network services that we saw before. So here it should be noted that we validate this using OSM and our PSEF solution. And as you can see in this figure, through this service, this video service, we were able to stream seamlessly two different video feeds. So one was to monitor a section of the road through the initial service, or the one colored in blue. And with that, we can improve the situational awareness of the municipal authority and let this authority to detect if an emergency occurs. And we have a second streamed video to the emergency vehicle to capture in detail the emergency and allowing the response team that it is in the vehicle to define an action plan. So to conclude this presentation, in this slide, we can see some of the lessons that we have learned with our work, in which it particularly stands out that the implementation of our NFV framework composed by an aerial and a vehicular NFV infrastructure, and also the realization of a vertical use case involving the public safety vertical to showcase the potential benefits of this framework. In addition, it is important to highlight that OSM had a leading role within our framework to enable the orchestration of different network services over this infrastructure, and also how our novel solution can be used to streamline the VNF configuration stage involving the service deployment. Finally, just a comment that as future lines to explore from this work, we would like to analyze in detail the use of the network slicing approach and study how this approach could be affected by the mobility of the nodes that we have within our NFV infrastructure. So that's all. Thanks for your attention. I don't know if we have time for questions, but they have said before we can see the offline if you want it.